close now with the cameras.
So, Johnny, how are you feeling about that?
Well, I feel pretty good. I feel pretty relieved. In fact, I feel overwhelmed. I'm pretty emotional here that this came to this. 15 months later, and I literally feel overwhelmed. I want to thank Mike Scott, the owner of the Yellowknife newspaper, for his support throughout this. I want to thank Sarah Heaton, my good friend and lone witness, who the judge said he believed, and that's because she was telling the truth. And I want to thank my friend Dave Bidini, who has come from Toronto each time that I've had a court appearance. I also want to thank all those people that supported me, both by buying my t-shirt that I had nothing to do with, I might add, but you know, I got an awful lot of moral support from people in Yellowknife, and that meant a lot to me, and I'm humbled by that.
So I saw at the end you looked pretty emotional, some tears coming down. What does it mean to see this all kind of come to an end after all these months?
I think it, more than anything else, it means that I can conceivably return to my job as the crime reporter for the Yellowknife newspaper, a job that I was extremely proud to do and thought I did well, and there's no reason that I can't return to that position now and continue to do what I thought was good work 15 months ago, and I can go right back to doing that again. I don't have an axe to grind with the RCMP. I never did in the first place. I write stories about them, good and bad. I wrote a story where two women's advocates were upset because a man who had been accused of a sexual offense was allowed to roam our streets for a couple of weeks before he was arrested, and they were upset that the public weren't warned about this gentleman roaming our streets. I didn't say I was upset. These two women said they were upset. Within weeks, the RCMP had a news conference changing their policies whereby this wouldn't happen again. People made the argument that I helped to make the streets safer for women in Yellowknife. Whether I did or I didn't is not the point. Instead of saying to me, "You're John McFadden, aren't you?" And some of them not, you know, being barred from their news conference and a general sort of rift developing between me and the RCMP. Frankly, they probably should have thanked me because I wrote a story that prompted them to change their policies to cover a gap that was there. They know that. I know that. Everybody knows that. So where this animosity came from, I'm not really sure. We all get called out. Nobody's perfect. My job is to write stories and tell the truth, and I believe I did, and that's all I did. And if I help make the streets safer for people in Yellowknife, I am proud of that. But I don't think it should have led to an acrimonious relationship between me and the RCMP, and that's hurt me and it's bothered me, and I begin to start to try and repair that immediately.
What do you think of the Crown for pursuing this?
I have no problem with that. I don't think that the police officers or the Crown thought that they were doing this trivially. They felt that I had obstructed them. I felt strongly that I had not. I hate to use that hockey reference again, but obstruction means getting in the way of an officer doing his job. And I felt strongly that I didn't do that. That one photo that's taken a little bit closer to the van than the others was because the officers had gone to both ends of the van. I didn't get in their way. I didn't put my camera into the van. There was no crowd to incite. I don't know anything about that. But I think the judge's decision speaks for itself. And I didn't disagree with a single word that he said. And I think Judge Malico is a learned judge and a sharp man. And I believe I feel strongly that he made the right decision today.
What's next for me?
I'm going to take the rest of the day off, and again, there'll be a discussion with my senior editors about whether I return to the crime beat or not, but I'm going to be pushing for that. I've been covering the police for 30 years, and I think I do it well, and I look forward to returning to that.
Do you think the judge's decision today has a broader meaning for journalists across the country? I know we kind of the story got told to a national audience. It seemed like it had quite a lot of legs across the country. Do you think this decision today bodes well for your colleagues working in other places?
I suppose so, but I'm not too focused on that. I mean, I do believe in freedom of the press, but at the same time, any person, any citizen should be able to do what I did that night. In other words, if you're standing on a public sidewalk and you're not impeding the police from doing their duty, We have to do that. And it's not citizen journalism. It's citizens making sure that the police are acting within the law and properly. I have no problem with that, and I encourage people to do that, frankly.
That's all. Good one for me.
Yeah. Thanks for your time, and everybody for coming. I appreciate it. Thanks.